attitudes. So moving towards our topic, we have to see that the earth is the main center of our study in the solar system. Are you getting me? So our scientists have always been fascinated by the earth shape. The shape of the earth look like a spherical object. It is proved by the Earth's photographs taken from the space, but it is not the perfect shape of the Earth. It is considered that geoid is the true shape of the Earth. Geoid means which looks like an orange. See here. Yes. So slightly flattened on the poles, North Pole and South Pole. Are you getting me? So it is slightly flattened at the poles. This shape is called geoid shape. So now question arises that how does anyone can study the globe? See, as we look at the globe, we see a fixed needle in a tilted manner. Which running through the globe, okay? So which is called its axis. The earth rotates on its axis. We can rotate the globe around this needle from west to east. How? Just as the earth rotates. The spherical representation of earth is called the globe, okay? The globe is a small model of the earth which represents the continent, oceans, countries, etc. Now the question arises again that how to locate a place on it. Okay, see, the earth rotates or spins upon an imaginary axis. The pole pointing towards the pole star, here the pole star means north, is called North Pole, and the pole opposite to it is called South Pole. Between the North Pole and South Pole, there is an imaginary line. See, North Pole and South Pole, there is one imaginary line is called the equator, and the equator, the line of equator divides the earth into two equal parts, okay? So it divides the earth, the equator divides the earth into two parts, into two halves, that is called hemispheres, okay? The north part of the equator is called the northern hemisphere, and the part below to the equator is called the southern hemisphere. They are both the equal halves. Are you getting me? They both are the equal halves. Now we have seen that the imaginary line that runs midway between the poles from west to east is called the equator, that we know. The another imaginary lines are drawn around the globe, which we can see here. These lines make the study of the earth easier. These lines make a pattern called grids. Are you getting me? Yes, grid. The crisscrossing of lines on the globe show the pattern. They cut to each other at right angles. The horizontal lines are called the latitudes, and vertical lines are called longitudes. There are 90 parallels in the northern hemisphere. 90 parallels in the northern hemisphere and 90 in the southern hemisphere. These imaginary lines are used as reference points. Okay? globe. So thus there are 181 parallels including the equator. See the equator. The equator represents the 0 degree latitude. The distance from the equator to the poles, equator to poles, the distance is the distance from equator to poles is 1/4 of 360 degrees. For example, 90 degrees, thus 90 degree north latitude marks the north pole and 90 degrees south marks the south pole. So all the parallels north of the equator are called the north latitudes. Similarly, all the parallels south of the equator are called south latitudes. All parallels, or this is called latitudes also. So all parallels or latitudes are in the form of complete circles. Are you getting me? And the equator is the longest parallel or latitude. Mark this sentence, that the equator is the longest parallel, the longest latitude. Okay? See, we have seen that the equator is the longest parallel or the longest latitude. The length of the parallels start decreasing as one moves away from the equator towards the poles. Okay? So the farthest latitude is to north pole, 90 degree N, means 90 degree north, and the south pole 90 degree S or 90 degree south. This is indicated by the letter N or S. I will show you an example so that you will understand it clearly. See, Chandrapur in Maharashtra means in India, and Belo Horizonte in Brazil, that is in South America. They are located on the parallels of about 20 degree latitude. But Chandrapur is 20 degree north of the equator, whether Belo Horizonte is 20 degree south of the equator. So we can say that Chandrapur is situated at 20 degree N, means north latitude, and Belo Horizonte is situated at 20 degree S or 20 degree south latitude. See figure number 2.2 on the in the geography textbook, page number 11. So my dear students, for today let's stop here. Tomorrow we will be discuss about important latitudes, heat zones of the earth,